Welcome to my Music Under the Lens series. In this video, we will explore the first of the four movements of the symphonic poem Fontane di Roma by Ottorino Respighi. The movement is dedicated to the fountain of Valle Giulia. Enjoy! Ottorino Respighi was born in Bologna in 1879 and died in Rome in 1936. He was a composer, violinist, conductor, and teacher. He was one of the leading composers of the early 20th century. Very famous among his compositions are those three symphonic poems dedicated to Rome, forming the so-called Roman Trilogy, that is, Fountains of Rome, Pines of Rome, and Roman Festivals. Fontane di Roma was composed in 1916 and first published in 1918. It was his first great success as a composer. We are dealing with a composition for a large orchestra inspired by something that enchanted Respighi during his stays in the city of Rome. Respighi himself explained that he composed this piece to reproduce by means of tone an expression of nature, and to impart a feeling for the principal events of Roman life. In the published score, Respighi provided his own illustrative notes for the piece. In this symphonic poem, the composer has endeavored to give expression to the sentiments and visions suggested to him by four of Rome's fountains contemplated at the hour in which their character is most in harmony with the surrounding landscape, or in which their beauty appears most impressive to the observer. The four moments of the day are dawn, morning, noon, and sunset. The four fountains in order are the fountain of Valle Giulia at dawn, the Triton fountain in the morning, the Trevi fountain at noon, the fountain of Villa Medici at sunset. We will focus on the first movement concerning the fountain of Valle Giulia at dawn. Respighi's musical culture was vast. He traveled a lot. He worked in St. Petersburg, studied in Berlin, and met musicians of the highest intellect. In his music, and obviously also in Fontane di Roma, we can find resonances with other great contemporary composers such as Debussy, Ravel, and Stravinsky, as well as with composers much farther back in time, back to Gregorian chant. In this symphonic poem, Respighi employs a big orchestra. Here we can see the instrumentation. It is really a very large number of instruments and performers. The percussion group is interesting. Timpani, cymbals, triangle, bell, glockenspiel. Even more interesting is the fact that in addition to the two harps, there is also a piano, a celeste, and an organ. Specifically, in this movement dedicated to the fountain of Valle Giulia, Respighi does not employ some of the instruments contemplating in the overall instrumentation. As you can see here, it doesn't use the three trombones nor the tuba. He doesn't use some of the percussions, nor the piano, nor the organ. I will show you the celeste here. It is a very special instrument with a crystalline timbre. This instrument, due to its charming sound, was used by various composers, such as Debussy, Ravel, and also Tchaikovsky, from whose ballad The Nutcracker we will listen to a fragment in order to get an idea of the celeste sound. We should imagine the symphony orchestra has a huge palette of painters' colors, Well, in our case, colors are sounds with all possible combinations. Respighi, like his contemporaries, possessed an extraordinary orchestration technique, so he really plays to find combinations of sounds evoking magical atmospheres. Let's consider the specific fountain we will deal with. We are at Villa Borghese. For the Universal Exhibition in 1911 in Valle Giulia, the architect Cesare Bazzani built twin fountains in front of the new building housing the National Gallery of Modern Art, at the end of the stairway leading to Villa Borghese. They both have a wide circular basin coming out of the ground, with a stem in the middle decorated with garlands, supporting an elegant bowl. From here, a jet of water flows into the lower basin, producing a fascinating play of light reflections. Let's now hear the first two bars of this piece. We are at dawn, we must not forget it. To evoke the charm of this particular moment in the day, Respighi uses very simple material, made up of two elements, a very high note played by the first violins, and an elegant flow of notes entrusted to the second violins playing softly with the mute. These two elements will often appear throughout this movement. In the third bar, something new happens. Respighi evokes a landscape with its magical atmosphere. As the composer noted, it depicts a pastoral scene with sheep passing and disappearing in the fresh and humid mist of a Roman dawn. The pastoral landscape takes shape in our imagination exclusively through the sounds and colors of the various instruments. Moreover, through a simple melody, first played by the oboe, to which the clarinet responds. Slowly, gently, this pastoral landscape begins to become increasingly concrete and to extend itself more and more in our mind. The fundamental aspect of this piece is that Respighi continues to create melodies or to reshape those we have already heard, depicting them in different ways. Every now and then, he intersperses moments of pure color, spots of colors. This is one, for example. These are just spots of sound, brush strokes of colors organized in a very intelligent way. They lead us to a particular moment. We are at dawn and we expect the sun to rise. And all colors change. A new melody begins. This short moment we have just heard is a pure poetic contemplation of nature. After this moment has closed in on itself, Respighi returns, as we can see in the score, to the tempo primo, and once again presents the melody we had heard at the beginning of the piece. It is as if the human vocal element returns to the foreground. But after that experience of sunrise, feelings have changed, and so also the choice of colors in the orchestral palette changes. We are almost at the end of this piece. Everything is gently vanishing, indeed we could say moving away from us. Only a melody remains, entrusted to the clarinet, which, as written in the score, goes morendo, dying away. What we have explored in this video, I remind you, is only the first of four movements, the first of four Fountains of Rome. Respighi will then continue his poetic and expressive research by composing other symphonic poems, such as Church Windows, Trittico Botticelliano, Pines of Rome, and Roman Festivals, to name the most famous. All these orchestral works are among the most performed compositions from the early 20th century. We have come to the end of our exploration. For a complete rendition of Fountains of Rome, as usual, in the box here below, I have noted a link to a performance that I particularly love. These videos show the beautiful images of the wonderful four fountains celebrated by Respighi. I hope you enjoyed my video. I thank you very much, and I would like to remind you of other videos in my Music Under the Lens series. I also invite you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you again, and see you soon.